Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's use a nucleophilic addition to a carbonyl to make a new alcohol. On the far right is an alcohol. We aren't given any reagents or starting materials. All we know is we need to make this alcohol through a nucleophilic addition onto a carbonyl. Well, that's a hint. Our starting material will be a carbonyl. An aldehyde or a ketone. That means our nucleophile will need to be over the reaction arrow. Where do we go from here? Well, there are three different groups on the alcohol carbon. Each of those three groups could have been added as a nucleophile. Three groups, three potential nucleophiles, three possible solutions. The three groups are a methyl, a phenyl, and a hydrogen. Let's start by adding a methyl. So our starting carbonyl will not have a methyl, it'll have a hydrogen and a phenyl. And our reagents, let's see, we'll add a methyl, we'll add that as an organometallic reagent, let's say a grignard. The methyl group attacks, makes a tetrahedral intermediate, that's our addition, and then in the second step, we need water to protonate the O- and make the alcohol. How about adding a phenyl? The starting carbonyl will have a hydrogen and a methyl. Add the phenyl as an organometallic reagent. Let's do an organolithium this time. The phenyl minus attacks, makes a tetrahedral intermediate. Add water in a second step to get the alcohol. How about adding the hydrogen? The starting carbonyl will have a methyl and a phenyl. Add the hydrogen as a hydride. We'll go with lithium aluminum hydride. Hydride attacks to give a tetrahedral intermediate. Water is the second step to give the alcohol. Reactions of carbonyls with strong nucleophiles to make alcohols are not difficult. The key step is to identify what group was added and envisioning that group as a strong nucleophile, whether a hydride or an organometallic reagent. All these reactions go through a tetrahedral intermediate.